Hi, it's Handy Andy Tech Tips here. Now, I don't need to tell you that Google Chrome is a great web browser. According to StatCounter, it's actually the most widely used browser in most countries around the world, as you can see by this map, where the green color means high usage of Chrome. Now, the reason why Google's browser is so good is that, along with Firefox, it broke the monopoly held by Microsoft's Internet Explorer and really encouraged browser makers to adopt more web standards. But in an effort to make their browser more streamlined, Google has actually removed some features from Chrome. In this video, we'll be taking a look at four of them. Number 1. OK Google. With Chrome 46, which was released in October 2015, this voice-activated search function was removed. It basically allowed you to search without ever touching your keyboard or mouse. You just say OK Google into your microphone, and everything you said after that would become a part of your search query. But if you really like this feature, then don't worry too much. You can still click the microphone icon in the search bar on google.com and do a speech-to-text search. Sure, you now need to use your mouse instead of just doing everything with your voice, but this shouldn't be too hard. Also, keep in mind that this feature has only been removed from the desktop versions of Chrome and is still available on the Android and Chromebook versions. Number 2, the Notification Center. This feature was also killed off in October of this year. It allowed web pages to put notifications on your desktop and aggregated them in one central place. Now, if you use a Mac, then you'll be familiar with the little bell icon in your menu bar. That was the notification center. But unfortunately, it seems like nobody really used it, so Google have removed it from their desktop versions of Chrome. However, it will still be available on Chromebooks. Number 3, CSS Vendor Prefixes. Now we start getting into the more technical items on the list, and this is one which really affected me as I like to develop web pages. So if you've never heard of it before, CSS is basically a language which allows you to add style to web pages. So you can change the font style of headings, add page backgrounds, basically do anything which involves the visual presentation of your site. But sometimes, the inbuilt features in CSS aren't good enough to create the design you want. So browser vendors started adding new features to the language. So that these new declarations didn't break the standard or cause compatibility issues for other browsers, they were prefixed. So Chrome had -webkit, Firefox had -moz, and so on. But when Chrome's rendering engine changed from WebKit to Blink back in 2013, it was announced that no new vendor prefixes would be created for Blink. Now, this means a couple of things. Firstly, this move effectively ends the implementation of custom CSS features into Chrome. It means that if the developers of Blink want to add a new feature to the CSS language, then they need to get it standardized with the W3C, so web developers will have to wait a very long time before they can use it. But there is an advantage. This also means the end to CSS prefix hell, where developers had to put in so many prefixes for all the different browsers that they were developing for that it nearly drove them crazy. Number 4, NPAPI, and I hope I said that right. So plugins have been supported in web browsers for a lot longer than you might think. The popular NPAPI architecture allowed plugins to be run inside the web browser for the first time. It was created for Netscape Navigator way back in 1995, so that's 20 years ago now. And amazingly, it was still widely used up until just a few years ago. But in 2013, Google announced that Chrome would be dropping support for the feature, but it was filled with security vulnerabilities and, because of its age and complexity, was a major source of crashing. Now it's 2015, and even though NPAPI has gone from Google Chrome, you can still run plugins in the browser using a new architecture called Pepper. So I hope you enjoyed the top 4 missing features in Google Chrome. If you did, then please subscribe to my channel for more videos like this, and do feel free to give this video a like. I'm Handy Andy Tech Tips, and thank you so much for watching.